And thank you for joining us on Let's Talk Tobago, where we tell you about the plans and initiatives of the Tobago House of Assembly and the impact that these have on you. I'm Colleen Holder, and this week we're coming to you with all the action at the World Food Day Festival. The Tobago House of Assembly says the Agriculture Administrative Complex is above board and legal. Tobago's drive for food security shows promise as the Blue Food and World Day food festivals are well attended. The Chief Secretary advises Olympian Kellyanne Baptiste that there is more to life than winning gold, and a test of endurance and teamwork as THA employees compete against each other in the organization's first ever triathlon.
Tobago, the THA Sports and Family Day is back. The action gets going with the Torch Run 2012 on October 19th. Around the island we go with schools, villagers, and NGOs starting at 5:30 a.m. at the Storm Bay Beach facility. And on October 28th, the THA Sports and Family Day starting at 9 a.m. at the Dwight York Stadium. So Tobago, get ready for the action, the excitement of the THA Sports and Family Day 2012. Celebrating our golden moments from October 12th to the 28.
Boy, girl, animal, place, and thing. No, it's not the childhood game. It's the annual World Food Day celebrations, and we are coming to you with all the action from the two-day event at the Dwight York Stadium. It's about people, crops, animals, plants, and Tobago culture at the event put on by the Division of Agriculture.
These are the boys and girls, the animals, this is the place, and oh, what a thing to see the Dwight York Stadium car park packed yet again for the annual World Food Day celebrations. Farmers showcased their pride livestock and crops, showing that they had indeed found the key to feeding the world. But the farmers weren't the only ones who got to show off their wares. In the FAO director's message, delivered by Representative Barton Clark, it said that we have the means to eliminate hunger and malnutrition once an enabling environment is put in place to allow producers to take full advantage of available opportunities.
FAO, together with the wider United Nations family and other partners, including the Committee for the Promotion and Advancement of Cooperatives and the Rome-based agencies, will continue to strengthen and support cooperatives as key stakeholders to open the door to new opportunities and to achieve our common goal of more food secure and a sustainable world.
Agriculture Secretary Gary Melville said even though agriculture today is not as vibrant as in the past, events such as World Food Day brings hope of food security.
The goal of food security is a goal that the division has had for many years now and has been seeking to bring to Tobago or to the lives of Tobagonians the ability for us to have food, adequate food available for our population and to reduce our dependency upon food coming from other sources. That goal is as important, in my opinion, as any of the other developmental goals that we have as an island.
Meanwhile, Chief Secretary Orville London explained that the event is an end and a beginning.
World Food Day signifies the climax of a number of activities which would have taken place during a particular year. And that is why I say World Food Day for me is a beginning, because it provides us with an opportunity to evaluate what has happened in the previous year. And as we move forward, make the adjustments so as to ensure that the next year will be even better.
The call was made by Agriculture Society Representative Orwin Dillon for persons to continue buying local.
This year, let us make a concerted effort to support Tobago by buying Tobago products and for manufacturing and processing companies to add value to our local production. Once again, as we cooperate one with another, let us grow what we eat and eat what we grow as we strive to improve food security on our island.
Sophie Guillaume, Department of Information.
It's the first time she's entered the competition at the Tobago Blue Food Festival, but Patricia Shepherd beat the old hands with what she called her good hand. Once again, here's Davia Chambers to tell us more.
Rain is synonymous with the Blue Food Festival, but this year it was not so, as the sun shone in all its glory for the annual event put on by the Division of Tourism. The indigenous cooks displayed their production and creativity with the root vegetable dashin, but one lady can be called the queen of blue food as she captured the majority of prizes. That lady is Patricia Shepherd, who is a first-time competitor at the Blue Food Festival, and she called her victory simply having a good hand.
Well, I was shocked. First time, first try, and I was shocked. Glad. Overall dish, probably that's the dashin au gratin with the fancy albaco and the gravy made out of dashin too for the fish. And then it had best dessert, which is a dashin mousse with coconut.
Patricia said that she has been preparing for weeks and she is satisfied that her hard work paid off. But next year, she says she is coming out on fire with more unique ways to prepare dashin.
This is the first year and I enjoy it and I wasn't too stressed, but I was just shocked to see that I went, I'll try again. But I'm coming real good and real hard.
Taking home the best creative dashin dish was Charlene Jun and best dashin beverage Carlton Campbell. Meantime, Secretary for the Division Oswald Williams noted that the fact that the food court kept patrons busy throughout the entire day is a good sign.
It means that people have come to savor the what we have produced from the dashin and the cuisine of the Northeast. And we are happy about that.
And in the 14th year of the festival, the Chief Secretary Honorable Orville London is still fascinated with the number of ways dashin can be prepared.
The boats, the layout, I think is excellent. The variety of food. And I think I continue to be quite fascinated by the number of ways that you can treat with dashin. I haven't sampled everything. If I did, I would not be able to be speaking to you. But what I particularly like is that people were not just focused on the entertainment. They were going around to the boat, they were checking the craft, they were sampling the food and so on.
The patrons of the event also enjoyed the day to its fullest.
Exciting from beginning. From the time you hit the shuttle, first of all, the shuttle is exciting. Free shuttle to bring you here is great from the beginning. People, food, everything from dashin. Just think of it, amazing. From drinks, kurma, chana, akra, everything. Just name it.
I eat one provision.
Dashin?
Dashin.
Will you be back next day?
Ice cream, everything. Yes!
This is cultural, this is enlightening to come and see all this is dashin.
I think that this one is better than what we had last year. And in terms of the setting, the layout of the place and everything. And of course, we have been good weather today.
The Blue Food Festival promotes tourism, builds the community, and creates economic activity. I'm Davia Chambers for the Department of Information.
She felt disappointed by her London Olympic performance, but as Chief Secretary Orville London pointed out to Kellyanne Baptiste, success does not always mean winning a gold medal. Back home for a short visit, the 2012 Olympic finalist visited the Chief Secretary. Omidara Mills reports on Ms. Baptiste's Olympic experience, her greatest challenge, and her preparations for Brazil 2016.
At the London 2012 Olympics, Tobago-born athlete Kellyanne Baptiste made it to the finals of the 400 meters and the 4x100 meters relay, the first time she's ever completed this feat. But despite not winning gold, Chief Secretary of London assured her that she still made Tobago proud.
Do not, equate success only with medals. I think we all appreciated your effort and your consistency, and we want to wish you the best.
Even though Baptiste felt that she failed due to her high expectations, she was grateful for the support given to her by Tobagonians for her performance at the London Olympics.
Even though in my eyes, I felt to some degree that I failed because I have high expectations of myself, the people that reached out to me, they still felt that I was successful, and that really helped pick me up from the slump that I was in, because I was really disappointed. And I just want to say thanks to everyone for the support that they have been giving me, you know, regardless if I get a medal.
With her years of athletic experience, 26-year-old Baptiste stated that she is not at her peak, and with the Brazil Olympics 4 years away, she's not about to lose focus on her training.
Myself as a track athlete, it's there are steps to get there. So next year for us, it's the World Championship in Russia. Then the year after that, it's probably a Commonwealth Games, and there's World Indoor. So it's so I think I would use those meets as markers and indicators of the things that I need to do and the things that I need to change in order to get to Rio 2016 at my best and give myself the best chance of getting a medal.
Confidence. That was Baptiste's greatest challenge, which she learned to overcome. And with her success in this area, this Olympic track athlete had some words of advice to upcoming athletes in Tobago.
I was just resilient in the fact that I wanted to be great. It didn't matter what it was I was doing. And I had a never give up attitude. And I would just tell them, it sounds cliched, but don't ever, ever give up. Just keep hard work and perseverance is always going to bring you success.
I am Omidara Mills for the Department of Information.
They are not professional athletes, but they ran, skipped, and crawled to show their fitness levels. From jumping through hula hoops to completing an obstacle course, Omidara Mills has the highlights of the Division of Health and Social Services Sports and Family Day.
With their month-long activities entitled Health Heritage, the Division of Health and Social Services had one day of fun and novelty games at the Boko Integrated Facility. Members of the division competed in activities such as March Pass, where participants portrayed the importance of exercising and cleaning up the environment. An exercise obstacle course race, musical chairs, and races for men and women tested the participants' speed. While teamwork was vital for activities such as tug-of-war, hula hoop jumping, and slider races. Delighted to see her staff moving, Secretary of the Division, Claudia Green-Duke, stated that all citizens depend on a proper health care system.
If you look back at our Olympians, it is our wellness and in the pink of their health that they could strive to win gold and bronze. And so we here must continue to develop our health system.
I am Umudara Mills for the Department of Information.
And after showing such vim and vigor on their own sports day, it was time for Division of Health employees to take part in the first ever THA Triathlon. The event was a forerunner to the THA Sports and Family Day, carded for October 28th, where all the divisions will go head-to-head in a range of events. But as we hear in the Sophie Guillaume report, the Division of Health faced stiff competition in the triathlon.
Where had everybody and bring it to me and I just finish off. But this is a man who really did very well. So,
yeah, well, I say thank to the Almighty for giving us health and strength today. Because I pray before I come out here and ask him to give me victory, which he answered my prayer. And I'm saying it's a team effort, an all team effort, and we all did well. The people who work behind the scene like Valana and all the others, we say thanks to them because they work extremely hard to make sure this become possible.
That was the winning team, the Division of Tourism and Transportation. From the get-go, they took the lead and kept it, The relay style triathlon began at the Black Rock Heritage Park, where the swimmers hit the water and made one lap around the marker, and then to the shore where they tagged their teammates who took the first leg of the run from Black Rock to Mount Irvin. The second leg ended at Bethel, where a third set of runners awaited their turn to be tagged. All the while, the tourism division held the lead as their runner was the first to reach the Lowlands Mall, where the cyclists took the mantle. From Lowlands to Shore Park, and then to the finish line on the Esplanade. Try as they might, the other competitors just couldn't catch the Division of Tourism, who were no doubt enthused about their victory. Sophie Guillaume, Department of Information.
You can now send us your comments to information@tha.gov.tt or visit us at www.tha.gov.tt, or please see the bottom of your screen for more contact information. We take a short break now, but when we come back, the Tobago House of Assembly responds to the Prime Minister's comments on the development of the administrative complex for the Division of Agriculture.
Tobago, the THA Sports and Family Day is back. The action gets going with the Torch Run 2012 on October 19th. Around the island we go, with schools, villages, and NGOs, starting at 5:30 a.m. at the Storm Bay Beach facility. And on October 28th, the THA Sports and Family Day, starting at 9 a.m. at the Dwight York Stadium. So Tobago, get ready for the action, the excitement of the THA Sports and Family Day 2012, celebrating our golden moments from October 12th to the 28th.
Chief Secretary Orville London says he welcomes any investigation into the affairs of the Assembly. Mr. London was speaking at a THA press conference where he addressed concerns regarding two multi-million dollar projects. Finance Secretary Dr. Anselm London, Senior State Counsel Alvin Pascal, and Deputy Chief Secretary Hilton Sandy all spoke out on the details of the proposed Bacalet Aquatic Center at the headquarters of the Division of Agriculture, Marine Affairs, Marketing and the Environment. The team was responding to the government's criticism of THA projects. Sophie Guillaume has more.
The two projects that are currently the focus of the Prime Minister are the Bacalet Aquatic Center and the Agriculture Administrative Complex at Shilvan.
The first thing I'd like to speak to is the headline, Stop Tobago Projects. I want to say two things about that. All the advice that I have been given indicates to me that the Prime Minister does not and should not have the authority to stop projects in Tobago, which fall under the ambit of the Tobago House of Assembly. The second point that I want to raise is that one cannot stop a project which has not started. The two projects that she indicated that she intends to stop, one of which is the Bacalet Aquatic Center and Indoor Complex. That project has not started. There is no contract, no agreement to start that project. Discussions have been going on with various entities over an extended period. No decision has been made, and therefore there is no project to stop. In the case of the Shilvan project, and I want to make it very clear, that project is a project for the construction of the administrative complex for the Division of Agriculture, Marine Affairs, Marketing, and the Environment. And therefore, it is not an agriculture building.
as many people believe. The second point that I want to treat with is the whole question of development in Tobago. And I want us as Tobagonians to understand the challenges faced by the Tobago House of Assembly. In the first place, the allocation to Tobago was less than the absolute minimum. Minimum of 4.03%, we got 3.9%. And I want to draw your attention to an article in today's Express, which quotes economist Vanus James as indicating that Tobago's GDP for 2011 of $2.61 billion is more than the allocation to Tobago. In other words, Tobago contributes more to the GDP than it gets out of the allocation. So they're not doing us any favors. And when you reach a point where you break the law, the Prime Minister is talking about breaking the law. The Minister of Finance has in fact broken the law by going against the Dispute Resolution Commission and actually giving Tobago less than the minimum 4.03%. And just to give you an idea of the challenges we in Tobago face when we have to source funding so that projects could either start or be continued. Housing and settlements, we asked for $285 million, we got $28 million. Now you would know $28 million at the cost of housing these days will build maybe 40 to 50 houses. Cove Estate, in a situation where we're looking to develop and to diversify, we asked for $65 million, we got $9.5 million. Our scholarship program, which of course, as you're aware, is a program which affords us in Tobago the opportunity to assist Tobago's young people wishing to access tertiary level education. And I want people to understand that. We asked for $10 million, we got $200,000. And the Young Professionals Program, which we're trying to introduce in order to give graduates and persons who are seeking employment and so on, after having qualified themselves, we asked for $20 million and we got $300,000. And the Bacolet Indoor Complex and Aquatic Center, the allocation from the Ministry of Finance for that facility was $200,000. So I want you to recognize that from the Assembly's perspective, there is no way in this century, not even in this generation, in this century, that we would be able to fund any major project in Tobago based on the allocation. And I want to state categorically that I welcome any investigation by any authority into the affairs of the Tobago House of Assembly. Because what we do in this administration, we do according to the advice that we get and within the law.
Meanwhile, Senior State Counsel Alvin Pascal brought the lease, which the Prime Minister claimed was missing pages. Pascal pointed out the document had been prepared by the reputable law firm of Fitzwilliam, Stone, Furness, Smith and Morgan.
If you open this document to page 2, you'll see it sells the transaction. Page 2, the lessor is seized and possessing fee simple of the lands described in the schedule here too. The lessee, the lessee, that's us, has agreed with the lessor to construct an office building facility, 82,954 square feet on the said land, called the office facility, in accordance with plans and specification here to annex at A. So all the plans of the building is annexed to the deed at Annex A. And it goes on here, on completion of the said office facility, the lessee will lease the lessor the office facility for a term of 20 years in accordance with the terms and condition of the draft deed of lease here to Annex and Mark B. If any attorney did not put this inside and when it's registered, he has to be mad because it's on page 2. If you look at clause 5 of the lease, it says here at 5B, at any 3-year anniversary of the tenancy hereby created, the lessee shall have the option, that's the THA, we could say that the THA shall have the option of purchasing the demised premises, which is the whole lease, the whole property, building and land, for the unexpired residue of the term hereby created. So you have a 21-year lease granted, but every 3 years you could exercise your option to buy. So you just pay off the balance. So within the 20 years of this lease, we could purchase it at any time. Not much of these transactions has a clause like this.
With Tobago receiving less than its share of the budget, Finance Secretary Dr. Anselm London spoke of frustrations with successive finance ministers regarding the shortfall on Tobago's allocation.
I have before me a copy of a letter. This was turned down by the minister at that time, where a major financial house in Trinidad and Tobago was willing to finance a lot of our projects, many, many projects in Tobago, that fell through, didn't get the approval. You talk again. And among the ministers, we started with Minister Yetming. We also spoke to the then Minister of Finance, Prime Minister, then, and also Prime Minister Manning. We also spoke to Mr. Enil. There's a huge exchange of correspondence between us and the Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Finance. And at every turn, the Tobago House of Assembly was put aside. One major finance house on Independence Square, O'Brien Lara Promenade, was willing to put its reputation and ours on the table to make funding available for many of the projects that we have seen in Tobago. In fact, the concern continued every single year. The Chief Secretary, in his correspondence to the new minister, Minister Hawaii, raised the matter again. How is Tobago going to move forward with its projects without? And if there is no borrowing, what you do is to find legal avenues, such as the lawyers here have indicated, through Bolt and other related financing. So I feel that the discussion, we must not divorce the current issues about wanting to interfere with Tobago's projects and so on, with the question of funding. The Assembly has tried at every turn, and that's the status of those types of engagements.
Deputy Chief Secretary Hilton Sandy said the issue with the Prime Minister could have been avoided if she had followed Section 31 of the THA Act, which makes room for regular meetings between the Chief Secretary and the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister has not responded to calls for meetings with the Chief Secretary.
Section 31 of the THA Act says that the Prime Minister and the Chief Secretary shall hold a regular discussion with the view to formulating administrative and legislative mechanisms for the promotion of harmony in the affairs of TNT. And I'm saying, if this was brought to the attention of the Prime Minister that something is wrong in Tobago, she could have called the Chief Secretary and have a discussion, say, look, I hear you are going into this transaction. In our opinion as a government, we don't think it's right. And the Chief Secretary would have now put all this documentation to the Prime Minister and say, look, based on of what was given to us by Hamel Smith and company, this is the reason and this is why we went into this transaction. And I want to go further to say, look, that the government of themselves also are doing a similar design, build, finance, operation, and maintain is in the budget document. Where the Minister of Finance saying that they will be doing private partnership development in the country. The only thing with this is that they will not own it, but they said they will design it. And in this case, because we are going out for several designs to come to you, the procurement will be different. But in this case, the design came with the package.
Sophie Guillaume, Department of Information.
And that's how we leave you on this week's edition of Let's Talk Tobago. On behalf of the Department of Information, I'm Colleen Holder, and we leave you now with some more images from the World Food Day Festival here in Tobago.